In today's video, we will take a look inside the TG113A Bluetooth speaker and also upgrade the battery as well, because the playtime of 2 hours on 50% volume is not enough for me. This is my first attempt at opening this, so if I break something along the way, you already know why, and hopefully you won't make the same mistakes as well. I had a hard time figuring out how to get the top part off, so I decided I will deal with it later and just start from the bottom. The bottom screws are basically underneath this foam cover, and we need to remove it with the help of a heat gun. You don't really need a heat gun, but it does make the job a lot easier. Just make sure you don't heat it up for too long. We have our T&G logo engraved on the plastic, and also the 4 Phillips screws that needs to be removed. I did not remove the rubber off the top because it looked like it was attached to the plastic, so I just left that on there. The blue and white wires are for the battery, and the red and black is for the speaker. I used my heat gun once more, then I slid off the fabric that was covering the plastic body. We have 6 more screws to remove before we have access to the battery and the speaker. So right here we have 1 passive radiator, a 14500 battery with a capacity of 500 milliamp hours, and lastly the speaker, which is rated at 5 watts 4 ohms. It's not a game, it's a rage thing. It's time to change out the battery, but before we do that, I'll show you real quick the writings that we have on the original battery. So this is the BMS board. BMS stands for Battery Management System. This is there to protect the battery from being overcharged or over discharged. We will hold onto this because we'll use it with the new battery. I will be using this 18650, which I salvaged from a defective laptop battery, and I also ran a discharge test at 500 milliamps, and I was happy to see that it can provide up to 2194 milliamp hours, which is a lot of capacity compared to the original, which only has around 500 milliamp hours. So when removing the nickel metal strips, be very careful because they're pretty sharp. I left the strips on in the beginning, but later on I decided that I didn't really need them. So my camera can't pick up the letters on the BMS, but it has a B+, which means that's where you connect the positive terminal of the battery, And of course, the opposite side is the negative. I added some solder to those terminals and later connected some wires. I am using a sandpaper here to sand both terminals of the battery, and that's to make it easier for the solder to stick. Everything is connected together now, so I'll do a test run before putting everything back. We have a blue light and also the startup tone, so the operation was a success. I'd like to thank whoever designed the inside of the case because they specifically made an area for the 18650 battery to go. So it was a relief when I found that out. Otherwise, I would be spending more time trying to figure out where to put the new 18650 battery. The TG113A, after the upgrade, now has a playtime of more than 8 hours on 50% volume and little over 4 hours on full volume. Anyways, thanks for watching and please leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it, and also please consider subscribing to the channel. Until next time, peace.